Okay, once again in this video we have a Dell Precision M4700, and in the last video, the previous video, we updated or upgraded the hard drive to 2 terabyte, and we put Windows 10 on it. So now I checked the BIOS on this and it's out of rev, which is going to give untold problems, especially with Windows 10 on it. It came with Windows 7, so I'm going to show, here's how to upgrade the BIOS on this Dell Precision M4700. So we're going to want to go to Dell.com. So I'm just using Microsoft Edge. That's what's on this computer by default. I'm going to go to Dell.com. There it is right here. Now I'm going to go to support. Product support. Now it's coming up, which product can we help you with? It knows that this is what computer is on here. It goes out and it detects it, okay? So I've also installed the Dell products support on here. So click on the Dell Precision M4700, select drivers and downloads, and then I want to look up BIOS. So under keyword, just type in BIOS, hit the little search magnifying glass. That's going to bring it up. Now let's go down to our results. And here it is right here. This BIOS. And it's marked as urgent, okay? So we're going to want to download this. You also got to make sure you have a charge in your battery when you do this. Dell wants them to have 10% charge. Okay, so in the bottom left corner of the screen, you're going to have the executable file. It says open the file. Open it up. It's going to ask you for permission to make changes to the computer. It's going to tell you what it's putting on there for the BIOS. Now it's going to compare what it's putting on there for the BIOS as to what you had. This is at A08. It's going to update it to A19. It's quite a jump. God only knows what kind of problems the customers will have with this computer. I've had them come back that the thing randomly shuts down because the BIOS was out of date. I try not to have a computer go out of here with an out-of-date BIOS. But I don't catch them all. Okay, so it just loaded the file for the new BIOS. Now after this reboots and starts up, it's going to start loading that BIOS. Back in the old days, some of you probably remember, you had to use a floppy drive. Flash drives hadn't even been invented. And you just load straight from the BIOS, straight from the computer. You could never go to Dell's website and get a BIOS update. Couldn't happen. So here it is. It's running the BIOS update. So it's around 25%. It doesn't take it too long to load it. This is going to take a few minutes because we're going from, A14 to A19? Maybe even worse than that. Right? So I did one last night. It was the Dell Precision M6700. Which is the same as this one, only with a 17-inch screen. But that's Rev A20. This is Rev A19. So there's probably some pretty important stuff on here. Probably some of it is to do with video. Some of it's to do with running Windows 10. You know, a lot can go wrong. They don't upgrade these BIOS for no reason. It's a lot of work for them to upgrade the BIOS, and they don't do it because everything's working fine. So always, always, always check your BIOS and always update to the latest BIOS version. Probably nothing more important you can do for a computer. Always check your BIOS. Even when it's up to date, check it every 6 months or so. Always check it. They won't come out and tell you that your BIOS is out of date either. That's one thing that you always have to check for yourself. Yeah, see, this is loading a lot on here. So it says, updating your system's firmware. So, BIOS, CMOS, firmware. It's all pretty much the same idea, right? Everything to do with running your computer. Everything to do with your operating system talking to the computer. Probably the most critical thing in your computer is the BIOS. So this has reached 70%. And it's dragging at 70%, but it's probably gonna start moving pretty fast after that. You can't turn off your computer, you can't remove power, you can't remove the battery, because then you'll end up with a brick. You'll end up with a useless computer. See, this is really working. The fan has just come on. This thing is going all out. This is putting as much pressure on this computer as it can handle. There's quite a few changes going on. Okay, so this is like a third section here. And it's coming up quite quickly. It's zipping right up to 100%. It says BIOS update successful. Okay, so it's going to restart the computer. And it's going to come up with that nice, clean, fresh, up-to-date BIOS. Nothing like it. Probably helps the memory run better. You name it. Windows 10 is going to run better. Video drivers are going to run better. I didn't look into it, but there's got to be plenty of fixes. You know? I get these computers and holy mackerel, they are outdated on the BIOS. So, usually before I even put in the new hard drive, before I do anything, I'll update the BIOS. Saves me from having to deal with a lot of problems. So there it is. Okay? You know, you can't really tell what it's done, but it runs plenty smooth. And it wasn't like not running smooth before, but God only knows what kind of problems it would run into that it would have once you start making this thing do some stuff and work. All right, that's it. But that's how you update the BIOS. It's a lot easier than it used to be. So I'll see you in the next video. Happy Sunday, everybody. Have a nice day.